Hello there everybody, it's Sally Cathcart here and welcome back to another Tuesday Teaching Tips. So today I'm just wanting to talk for a bit, I'm not sure what I'm going to say actually, about passing on kindness. My husband and I were out for a walk not long ago and we passed a shop, or a cafe actually, that said pass it forward, and we ended up having quite a debate about what that meant, pass it forward. And actually passing forward is the opposite, of course, of payback. Pay it forward, which is the opposite of payback. And payback, I think, as being rather negative. You get your own back on somebody. But pay it forward, is about when you've experienced kindness yourself and actually passing on that kindness to other people. And I just feel in today's time, that is important in life generally, but in today, in 2020, it is more vital than ever that we all pay it forward if we possibly can. And not everybody can, I know, because I know some people are really, really struggling, but if you can, then just think for a moment about how you can pay it forward. So for me, I'm really wanting to support performing musicians. I consider that as teachers, we are really very fortunate on the whole. Yes, okay, some pupils have stopped learning, some students have stopped. However, we are still able to earn an income on the whole. Performing musicians who do nothing else but perform, a lot of them have nothing to do. They haven't had a gig in months and months. And I'm hearing stories from friends and colleagues who know people who have had to go and get jobs in butchers, in supermarkets, anything in order to be able to earn an income because they can't make music. So my paying it forward at the moment is very much to do with, you know, if I see a busker in the street, often fabulous buskers, I have to say at the moment, then I'm giving them some money. Supporting a local our local Newbury festival, which is a superb world-class festival, looking for money for running costs. So I've tried to make a donation. And I consider myself so fortunate because at the moment I am in that position. However, let's just think about other things that we could do to pay it forward. And maybe if you've got some spare music, you could maybe pass on some of that music. You know, look at all this music I've got here. Do I need it all? No, I don't think I do really. But maybe there's other people who would really benefit from that. Or maybe we could think about students who we know parents are struggling with money. Maybe we could give a series of lessons for free. Or maybe we just renegotiate the way that we do lessons. So we offer lessons every 2 weeks or even 3 weeks, because that's better than letting them stop completely. For them, you know, lessons can be a lifeline. What about organising a charity concert, maybe for yourself, that you play and raise some money for the charities, because the charities are really struggling as well. Maybe get your students involved so that they get to play. Or how about contacting the local care home and seeing if you can organise a Christmas carol concert for them, an online one that they could all listen to. We've all got to be reaching out, I think, and touching each other in a very virtual way, because it's not going to get easier between now and 2021. But if we can be kind to each other, then it helps us all to move forward in time. I've just shared a few of my thoughts about being kind, paying it forward. I'm sure there's loads more ideas, and I'd love to hear from any of you who have got some thoughts about how we can continue to be kind to each other, even though really a lot of the time we're not able to meet up in person. So pay it forward if you can, be kind, pass it on. Thank you all so much for watching, and do take care wherever you are in the world. Bye bye for now.